Les Paul model, Epiphone, Gibson.
Looks like somebody was eating it. No, it looks like they took it to the car wash or something. I don't know. We'll get all that shit off it. This just needs a setup, but we've got the old sharp fret ends again. Jesus. Oh, well. Keeps things rolling.
I'm going to start asking you guys what to do next. I forgot. The neck looks straight-ish. Straight, kind of. But we really want to make sure that all works. So we'll take off the cover that says Gibson. What the hell? Is that? Did they add that or is that on there? That's Epiphone's way of telling Gibson they suck? Or Gibson's way of saying it's okay that Epiphones are better? Okay. Epiphone, am I remembering right? 4mm again.
I just want to make sure it works. I'm not really going to worry about it because we got to take all the strings off.
Get the fret end sorted out and start over. Yeah, it works beautifully. So we'll just stop there. Throw that in a box of bins. Of bins of parts and parts and pits. And peel the strings off this and see what it does. I assume it makes sound. That seems, you can't quite see that, but that's loose. All right. So we'll have to fix that. And that's loose. So we'll have to fix that. And okay, strings off, away we go.
And suddenly the machine turned itself on into record.
I have no explanation for the way things happen sometimes. I'll just take it. It wanted you to see my elbow. Alright. Loosening off the strings. So we're gonna get all these off. We'll just set the neck straight and then I will figure out which weapon I will need to use to get rid of those sharp fret ends. They're nasty. Wow. Not nice.
So, it's just a good lesson. And just be careful what you use to clean your guitar, if you care about it at all. Best thing is just a clean cloth, and if you wipe it off after you play and sweat all over it, I don't know what's on here. But I love this stuff. It's biodegradable, user-friendly, smells nice, doesn't leave any residue, usually takes off most of any of the crud that other dinglings put on the guitar. So, I love those guys. They sent me other stuff, but I love them most for their sprays. Okay, back to the sharp fret end dilemma. After doing this way too many times, I found that no one tool is my friend. See, that's not sharp hanging over the edge, but it seems it's going to be this one, I can tell. It's right in there where the binding is and the fret meet. Very difficult to get through. This has that function, right? I'll try and show it. See, it's got abrasions on the side and a safe edge to do what I'm doing with that one. But the corner just is not as tight. And it tends to want to jump off. This one is super ground at 90 degrees. With the safe edge. Come on, baby. That's going to be the one all the way along. Everyone I can find. And even the ones I can't find.
Let's try and get a really good tight shot of what's going on here. So it's like. And some will say I'm doing this with no protection. Well, I kind of got to do that because I want to be able to see exactly what I'm doing.
I start gobbing tape all around this. It's such a tiny amount right where the binding meets the fret. Right there. This one's working better. Tiny little razor object. Still right there, another one. Excuse my beat up hands and dirty nails and messed up stuff. I think we pretty much got them all. Doesn't take much to make it feel uncomfortable. There we go, beautiful. Just gonna go over everything with fret erasers. And we'll grease up the fingerboard a little bit. I notice a tiny bit of fret wear. Nothing to really worry about at this point. Maybe in a year from now if you play it every day. Stay tuned. Okay, we'll do the old camera lock off for the old instantaneous before and after shots. Movie magic. Observe, focus your eyes. And the after. Aha. All right. What's next? Like I said, I'm going to start asking you folks what to do next. Finish cleaning it up. And let's get strings on it.
And I got ahead of myself. I promised to investigate loose controls. And also I can get the whatever that is off the back of this guitar, my gosh. Suction pig. Okay, which one would, that one's wiggling around, that one's wiggling around, they're all wiggling around. So we have to pop all the knobs off, and we're also gonna have to pop that off too. The usual shit, no locking washer on the back. The way they try to achieve this is they put opposing nuts, one on front, one on back, which never works. So we'll get that fixed up. Let's get the schnobs off it. Couple things missing. That guy on the back. Oh, look, I'm leaking. How the hell did that happen? Let's string up and set up and go sit down. I did set the neck straight before I put strings on this and tuned it up. So, might be close, might not be. Not at all. Choke, choke, must loosen. Just means it stayed dead straight. I am not knowing or remembering. Are these equipped with a two-way truss rod? We may have to find out, because I'm about loosened to death. It's not like the Alice Cooper record, Love It to Death. I see this just spinning loose. I don't think it's catching the other direction, kids. Oh, wait a minute. Look, it is. Took a long time to get there, though. So, see, I could have been fooled. I could have given up after a bunch of turns. We're almost there. See what happens. See if it works the opposite direction. Like you'd want it to. Well, it's catching. I'm going to call that perfect. Okay. Well, that's good to know. See? Gibson don't have that. Not much left to see here, folks. There's more studious job I have to look at, I wanted to look at before I went to bed, which is Whoa, a broken headstock on a Gibson. Imagine that. That's set way too low. That's right where it wants to be. So we'll just adjust that a little bit. Retune. Oh, then there, before I lacerated myself, the missing part was also that tiny little outer washer. No. Actually, everything on, every control was loose, even the toggle selector switch. Every control. The output jack. Oh my word. Oh, what do they give me down here? Good shot of my elbow. I'm just adjusting the tension a little bit on one of the tuners. It'll pick me up height. That's a little too close. That'll work. That's okay. That's too close. This is when they fall down inside on me, right? Yeah, I like that one. I'm not gonna chance it. That's gotta drop down. It's almost touching. I see a pole piece that's falling down in there as well. Why that would happen, I do not know. Will it come back up to the top? Wax or something in there. I don't know, maybe these are good pickups. Maybe they're not. What's that pile of shit there? Just crap. Alrighty. Instonation. I don't even have to make you listen. Or maybe I do. That is the most anemic rhythm pickup. Something messed up here. This is hot as devil. This is dead as dog. I'm going back in here with the meter because I think that front pickup is dead-ish. Right? So we got some better light going here. I figure out what does what here. Okay, that's from the switch. That's the output jack. That is the hot off that guy. Okay, I'll be back in a second. Any ground will do. So, one pickup. Come on now. ohms. Let me guess which pickup that is, the one that doesn't work. So, back to the other guy. Come on now. You can do it, David. Oh, there it is. The other pickup, which works. Interesting. Oh, more investigation is needed. My eyes are deceiving me here. That's what I want to read. The other side guy. Come on. Catch. Why am I not catching what I want to catch in there? It's that guy right there. Gotcha. I think. 3k ohm, which sucks. And this one is going to be where it should be, like up around 10. Yeah, something's wrong with that front pickup. Once again, never cut the strings to the end. So now I will let the guy know that, well, what has happened now? Something wrong with me, amp? Obviously, my wiggling around back in there. Maybe something happened when I tightened up one of the controls.
Okay, once again, never assume anything. It's the actual volume pot. I've bypassed it. Alright. I'll revert here. Sorry for the shit camera. Okay, bypassed everything. That works great. Bypassed everything. Should be dead. I might have something. I'll just probably swap it if I do. This guy's a good guy, he always comes to me, and he's a nice guy, and he's my friend, so three reasons. All the great links are below for things, and I'll look through my pickups and see what I have to help him out here. And yeah, something like that. I think I quit today. I'm not going to get as much done as I wanted to, but that's sometimes the way it goes when you end up in the soup. Special shout out to my patrons, as always. Facebook group is still alive. You can get a sticker, you can get a Penny Black CD, you can just Twitter me, you can subscribe, you can be good to each other and be safe. Cheers, folks. See, I bet you thought the video was over, but it's not, because I found a pickup, and guess what it's out of? An Epiphone. And guess where it's going? Into this thing. Let's release the dead one out of the back first. Release the wires.
That has to be one of the biggest tail chasers I've been on in a long time. Short of rewiring it, in the end, it wasn't the pickup. Wasn't the switch. Wasn't the volume control. It wasn't even the tone control. So what happened, and I had to pull everything out basically to figure it out. Remember at the beginning of the video when every control was loose? Okay. The tone control on the rhythm pickup rotated slightly. Not a big deal, but there was a tiny little hair of wire off the hot lug on the tone control that was touching the shielding, which isn't really conductive but sort of conductive enough to suck all the output out of that and make it sound like a bad pickup. Like I said, I've heard bad pickups over the years, and you know, when the output is seriously diminished, and I walked through all the wiring as I could from looking at it from outside with the meter, test the switch, everything tested out, except the meter didn't show that tiny little ground fault that was enough to just kill the output of the pickup. Nice guitar now. So there you go, it's not over till it's over. And as I've said before, folks, I'm not infallible. Sometimes it's good to make a few mistakes. Keeps you on your toes, right? I shouldn't say mistakes, but just a puzzle that just, you know, I wouldn't have slept right if I hadn't been able to suss this out tonight, because it was just like, well, what's wrong? There's nothing wrong. Everything inside there looks exactly the way it should. Molly Meter Maid says it's great. Test points say it's good. Anyhow, once again, as I did mention, I really wouldn't have been able to solve that unless I started pulling out stuff to see what was not right. I thought the tone pot was faulty in the end, or defective, only to find out it was just loose controls and silly little wires. Anyway, now this is the end, so you can go back to the end if you've watched farther and pretend it's the end, because all the great links are below. Be safe, cheers, be good to each other.